Next we have Ilmari from Finland. Pranam Acharyaji, a month back I asked a question about numbness and how it affects my life. You gave me a good lesson on self-centeredness and explained that if I am not able to do much for myself, then I should start working for others so totally that I forget myself. There is one thing I do not understand. I, the self-centered one, knows only self-centered action. If that is the starting point for helping others, then won't that too turn out as a subtle selfishness, a kind of do-gooder thing? With gratitude, Ilmari, Finland. It's okay. It's not self-centeredness that is problematic, Ilmari. Misplaced self-centeredness is problematic. Incomplete self-centeredness is problematic. When you say that you are being self-centered, what is it that you are centered on? That which you are calling as the self, do you know it? Know it and then be self-centered, it is okay. No problem. In fact, there is actually no option but to be self-centered. Whatever man does, he would always be self-centered. Doesn't matter whether you are the lowly looter or the highest saint. Both are self-centered. It's just that one knows the self and the other does not. One operates with a vague conception of the self. The other one sits firmly with total clarity of the self. Nevertheless, self-centeredness is common amongst the two. So, look at your tendencies, see what is it that you want. If by self-centeredness you mean the common selfishness, try being selfish and see whether it fulfills you. Why should we blindly or just moralistically declare that selfishness is bad? Let's give selfishness a chance, a fair chance. If selfishness can fulfill you, go ahead. If not selfishness, what is it then that would work for you? Surely not selflessness. If selfishness doesn't work for you, then go for deeper selfishness. A deeper understanding of the self. Work in your own self-interest. But know at least what the interests of the self are.